What's up guys? In this tutorial I'm gonna show you how to convert any 3D printer into a powerful 2.5 watt laser engraver capable of cutting wood and engraving into almost every material. So, we are gonna start this project by firstly choosing the right laser module for our needs. Starting with 500 milliwatt laser, you will only be able to engrave some shapes into wood, plastic or leather, and you can get that one really cheap for $35. Furthermore, with higher power output lasers, you're able to engrave deeper, quicker and also cut some plywood, and that's the reason why I chose 2.5 watt laser, which is just strong enough to cut 4 mm plywood with multiple passes. And yeah, when handling with lasers, don't forget to put on some safety glasses. So, I firstly detach a fan and extruder and remove the main holder so I can drill 2 holes for the screws that are gonna secure a laser to the printer. By the way, all the links of the lasers will be down in the description below. Secondly, we're gonna need 12V to 5V voltage regulator, which is necessary to control the power output of the laser. 3D printer fan port provides 12V at full power, but laser TTL module only accepts a voltage up to 5V, so that's why we need a voltage step-down regulator. So after soldering that together, I connected laser diode, fan, TTL port and main power input to the small motherboard that you receive with the laser. For the main power source, I'm gonna use this regulated DC power supply, but you can use any 12V power adapter capable of providing at least 2 amps. Now, let's secure the laser to the main holder with 2 screws. For best performance, I would suggest you also drill some additional holes for the airflow, but I didn't feel almost any heat generated by the laser, so I guess that's not that important. After that, I connected a 5V regulator to the 12V fan port, which is gonna send the command how strong the laser should be during engraving process. The last thing is to connect the motherboard with the main 12V power input, and that's it. Now we can start calibrating the laser by firstly finding the right focus point. Auto-home all axes and try to turn on the fan somewhere from 1 to 255. As you can see, the laser is turned off at 0 and outputting the maximum power at 255. Now I would suggest you place a piece of paper on the bed and reduce the power to a minimum so we can better see if our point is in focus or not. You can simply adjust that with a small knob on the laser itself. After you manage to do that, let's hop to the computer and download the needed software for engraving. Firstly, download an Inkscape software and 2 plugins for laser engraving. Again, I'll put all those links in the description box below. After installing the Inkscape, extract both plugins and copy the content to the written location. Now simply open the Inkscape and firstly define the workspace of your printer. After that, import your favorite logo and vectorize it by clicking Trace Bitmap command. Also, don't forget to resize the image to the final dimensions and place it in the left bottom corner. So now, the first plugin we're gonna use is the one that are going to fully engrave the whole image on our material. Choose the right output folder and set the speed around 1000 and click apply. The G-code will be generated in the text file, so open it and replace TXT ending with .gcode and that's it. As you can see, that method is pretty slow, but it can engrave some really nice logos and also grayscale images, but I'll cover that up in the next video. So the second method is almost the same, you need to set the right engraving speed and how many passes you want, which is very practical if you want to cut some plywood. I managed to cut balsa wood with only a few passes, but that's not the most amazing part. 2.5 watt laser is also capable of cutting some 4 mm plywood, but it takes a bit more time and much more passes, but all in all, it's very practical equipment for all tech and DIY enthusiasts. And yeah, if you're into electronics, you would also be able to create your own circuits and many other things. If you have any questions about the build, I would love to answer them and help you with your problems that occurred during the build process. Thank you again for watching. Lots of cool projects and tutorials are coming up soon, so hit that subscribe button and I'll see you next week. Peace.